Dear brothers and sisters, it gives me great joy to be able to spend another Sunday with all of you. As we gather together, it's very interesting to know that something very astounding happened just a few weeks back in the month of February. We as human beings were able to land a rover on Mars. The people at NASA who spearheaded the project were able to put a rover called Perseverance on Mars after it had traveled for around 7 months. And when we think about getting to Mars, where when you break into the atmosphere of Mars, you hit temperatures like 2300 degrees Fahrenheit. For the spaceship to be traveling at 12,000 miles per hour, and just in a matter of 7 minutes to be able to land it, the process of getting the rover away, the process of having a parachute so that it could go from 12,000 miles an hour to about 200 miles an hour, and then to be able to slow down, to be able to land at a specific point far away on Mars, is remarkable. And when we look at the efforts that would have gone into reaching this great feat, we find that we as human beings have always explored. We've explored this earth, and then we started to go into outer space. To think about the efforts that would have been put to make this landing of the rover on Mars to be successful shows us how much diligence there would have been to make sure that the whole process goes well. I'm sure that the planning would have gone on for years and years and years. And many engineers would have made models, and they would have tried things, and they would have experimented with one thing or another. There's so many mechanisms to think about, so many materials to think about to withstand the journey all the way to Mars, you know, from Earth. And you know, thousands and thousands and thousands of people would have very diligently worked to make this successful. Now, I'm not here giving a lecture on science, but I'm here to make a point, to make all of us understand that we who go on the spiritual way, we who want to know God, we who want to find God, we who want to experience God, can learn from what has happened with the landing of this rover, which is a very interesting name, Perseverance, on Mars. When we start to think about how one reaches a goal, a few ingredients are needed. In anything that needs to be developed, the first thing that's very important is to make use of methods that have been proven before. So all the knowledge that NASA would have had over the years of landing on moon, of other space travels, all that the great scientists there would have learned they would have wanted to put that into use in this project. It's not that you have to reinvent the wheel all the time. We as individuals need to build on what we know already. And all the knowledge which we have is very, very helpful because it then guides us to what can be experimented and what new things can be done. So when we start to think about the spiritual way, we know that in many faiths, in all traditions, all walks of life, saints and mystics have come. And they've talked about their meeting with God, their communion with God. They've talked about ways and means by which you experience God. And what is very interesting is the words might be different, the languages might be different, but there's a commonality in what they use to get to their goals. They all sat in silence. They all took the chatter of the world outside away. And in this silence, they connected with the creative power, the power that brought all creation into being, whether it's called the holy word or the naam or the shabd or the light and sound of God. And as they connected with this divine light and sound of God, then they were uplifted. They were exploring regions beyond the physical. And that knowledge of being able to connect with the divine light and sound of God is available today. Saints and mystics have talked about their ways, they taught it to their disciples. And through techniques, we can sit in silence. And through help and guidance, we can be uplifted into regions beyond the physical. So the knowledge of being able to experience God is there already. We need to tap into it. We need to make use of it. It's available to us. If we use it, we will be benefited. If we don't use it, it just sits there laying by itself. So one of the most important things when we try to achieve something is to make use of all the knowledge which is already available. And in the spiritual arena, there are writings after writings of the great saints, there are teachings after teachings of the great saints, there are there's experiences that they had on the spiritual journey, and the methods that they have used are available. And so that mechanism is available to be able to get to our goals. The second thing which is very important is to have a desire to reach our goal. There needs to be a desire to be able to do something. You know, all the people who maybe work in NASA and all the people who work in the space program have a desire to excel and do something good for humanity, to explore outer space so that we can learn more about the workings of Earth. And so there's a desire to reach their goals. The goal is to explore objects in outer space. Their goal is to know more about this physical universe. And so the desire to get to that goal is there, and this is why thousands and thousands of them work so hard to create new systems, to come up with new ways of being able to find out more about this whole universe. It's the same thing if we want to find our merger in God. It's the same thing if we want to experience God. There need to be a great desire in us to know God. It should not be that someone else is telling us to do something and we do it. It's not like as children, our parents tell us to do something and we do it, whether we want it or not. A desire to know God, a desire to truly know ourselves, a desire to be able to find the connection between our real self and God is needed. And so that should become a ruling passion of our life. If it will become a ruling passion of our life, then only are we going to be able to reach our goal. Unless we have this passion in life to get to our goal, we'll never reach there. Otherwise, you know, it's another activity to do, and so then you spend a little time here, a little time here, a little time here. So a desire to reach our goal is very important. A third thing which is very important is to concentrate and focus on whatever we want to do. I'm sure that everyone associated with the SAFE program must be very concentrated and very focused on whatever part of the project they're working on, so that that part could be done properly, optimally, so that the whole project keeps on going well. For a project that big, there must be thousands and thousands and thousands of mechanisms that need to be put together to be able to get to your goals. Thousands and thousands of different activities that need to be done. Thousands of things that need to work with each other properly. And each group of people who work on them need to be very concentrated and focused. If they're not concentrated, they're not focused, they start trying to think about in the mall or the family or taking the kids out to the doctor or, you know, buying a new house or something, then they won't be able to get the job done. It's the same thing in the spiritual arena. We need to be concentrated, we need to be focused. We need to be concentrated so that our attention is on God. We need to take our attention away from the world. We're living in the world, but we need to take our attention away from the world. We can't have, you know, our home or our children or our work or our relationships or other activities that we're involved in distract us from our goal. Unless we are concentrated, we're not going to be able to be focused towards our goal. And it's the focus which is required, so that no distractions are there, so that the unfoldment of the spiritual arenas can happen. And so it's very, very important that we be concentrated and we be focused. You know, the process of getting something done is one which takes us to this fourth area, which is persistent. The name of the rover is very interesting, perseverance. Perseverance comes with persistence. People who must be working on this project, because it is said that 40% of all the projects which were related to the mass were successful, 60% were not. So if something is not working, it doesn't mean you give it up. So you need to be persistent. You need to keep on doing it again and again and again until you perfect it. And look at all the efforts everyone would have put in who's associated with this project to make a perfection on being able to send a rover, you know, on a flight for close to 7 months. And sit there in front of their computer and watch on the screen what is happening. You need to be focused. You need to be concentrated. You need to be able to see what's happening and put all your energies there so that you can guide the project in the right direction. And it's the same thing with trying to know God. It's the persistence. What many people do is, when they find out that meditation is the way, they say, oh, I'll meditate. And they read the writings of the great saints and mystics, and they talk about experiences after experiences. And they think, yeah, when I sit down and close my eyes, I should get that on day one. And then they don't get that total experience. They get something, but not that total, and they try for a few days, they say, ah, this is not working. We're not persistent in being able to reach our goal. But those who are persistent, those who sit day after day after day, are the ones who are going to reach their goals. All the great saints and mystics who have come into this world have said something very similar to this. That each and every one of us can know God. We are a part of God. We are an extension of God. We have a birthright to know God. We just need to be focused in the right direction. If our attention is only going to be in the world outside, that's all we'll find out about. We need to take our attention from the world outside, and we need to focus it within ourselves. God is within each and every one of us, and the mechanism of experiencing God is called meditation or inversion or going within or sitting in silence. These are various names for similar techniques. The key is to keep our attention focused within, and that only happens if our mind can be stilled. To still the body is easy. We find a quiet place, we sit down, we don't change the atmosphere, there's no noise in the area, we close our eyes, we can withdraw all our five senses. What is difficult is to still the mind. As soon as you close your eyes, you'll be bombarded by thoughts. Thoughts are being generated by the mind. The mind doesn't want us to know God. The mind wants us involved in the world outside. So it distracts us very easily. So we need to learn the technique of dealing with the mind. We need to focus the mind on God, not on the world outside, because if it's focused on the world outside, that's what we'll gain from. We need to gain God's knowledge. We need to experience God. We need to be with God. We need to be in a state where the spiritual arena is starting to open up for us. And so we need to still our mind. And stilling our mind, the technique to still our mind is called Simran. Simran is a technique by which we repeat God's name. And so when we sit in a place which is quiet and we close our eyes, in front of us, light will sprout forth once we are able to still our mind. And so as we close our eyes, we repeat God's name mentally, not out loud. If we do it out loud, our ears would hear it. We would be distracted to the world outside. So we do a mental repetition of God's name. And as we do a mental repetition of God's name, then our attention is on God. And when our attention is on God, then with God's grace, the unfoldment of the Creator starts to happen. It begins with flashes of lights, circles of lights, lights of various colors. It seems like they're coming and going, or they're in circle. What is actually happening is that the light of God is within each and every one of us. As we concentrate, we experience it. As we are distracted, light is not experienced by us. To us, it seems like darkness. With time, as our focus and our concentration get better and better and better, the light seems to stabilize for us. And then with practice and with time and with persistence and perseverance, we get to states where many, many other vistas open up for us. Vistas which give us love, which make us experience God's love. Vistas which give us peace. Vistas like we've never experienced before, which put us in a state of bliss. And when we have those kind of experiences, then we want to have them more and more and more, because they put us in a state of joy like we've never been before. So the key is to be able to gain from whatever we experience in life. So this rover going to the Mars is a good example for us to keep in front of us. And know that we can go on an inner exploration. We just need to be sure that we are concentrated, we are focused. We need to be sure to know what our goal is, what is it that we want to experience. We need to be sure that we are persistent. And when we do that, when we use all that is available to us from before, which is the teachings of the great saints and mystics and the techniques that they used to experience God. So when we put all of these together, then we ourselves will also be able to get to know God in the shortest possible of times. Life in this world is limited. Each and every one of us is one day physically going to die. Whether 60 years, 80 years, 100 years, little more, little less. We need to make use of this time properly. And the earlier we start, the more focused we are towards our goal, the better our chances of getting to our goal. So let us meditate for a few minutes. Please sit as comfortably as you can. Close your eyes very gently, just like you close them when you go to sleep. Your eyeball should be straight, focus 8 to 10 inches in front of you. As you close your eyes, those of you who have been initiated in the mysteries of the beyond, please do your Simran. Those of you who are new here, please repeat any name of God that you feel comfortable with. You can also use a name which will give you peace or give you calm. Keep all your attention in front of you. In the darkness, light will sprout forth. Just keep your focus right there. I pray to God Almighty and to the three great masters of the past century, Hazur Baba Savan Singh Ji Maharaj, Param Sant Kripal Singh Ji Maharaj, and the gracious Master Sandarshan Singh Ji Maharaj, to help each and every one of us here connect with the divine power within and to experience the divine light in its effulgence. We'll be sitting for a few minutes. I'll be getting you out of this meditative state at that time. And my best wishes are with each and every one of you. Please leave off. Chhod dijiye ji.